So just like with Newton's other two laws, most people are aware of some version of Newton's third law. If you ask people what's Newton's third law, most students will tell you for each action there's an equal and opposite reaction. But again, like what our common versions were for Newton's first and second law, there are important details that are missing here. So just to be clear, action and reaction were Newton's words for forces. So one way to read this, just sort of modernizing the language, is to say that for each force, there is an equal and opposite force. So with that in mind, let's look at this scenario. So here I'm told I got a box of mass m that rests on a horizontal surface. And the question asks, are the weight of the box and the normal exerted on the box by the surface a Newton's third law pair? Are these two forces, do they satisfy Newton's third law? And so I'll give you a second to think about this and come up with an answer before moving on. Okay, so the answer here is actually no. So even though these two forces are equal in magnitude and point in the opposite directions, they are not a Newton's third law pair because of the important details that are missing. So let's reframe Newton's third law into a more complete form. So for a force that object A exerts on object B, there is a force of the same type that has the same magnitude but points in the opposite direction that object B exerts on object A. So one of the things that we can do to help ourselves sort of identify Newton's third law pairs more clearly is to be more explicit in the way we label forces. So up until now, we've mostly focused on what type of force. So with our subscript. So F sub n is a normal, F sub g is the gravitational force. But we can add more information in that subscript. So our subscript can include not just the type of force, but acting on what object and caused by what object. So we can talk about the gravitational force as the gravitational force exerted on the box by the Earth. Okay? So with this in mind, we can relabel the two forces that are in our diagram. So the gravitational force exerted on the box by the Earth, that one we've already talked about, that's the one that points down, the force due to the box sitting in the Earth's gravitational field. The normal force is the normal force exerted on the box by the surface. And so again, there are a couple important things that suddenly start to pop out that are reasons why these two forces can't be Newton's third law pairs. So one of them is that if we think about a Newton's third law pair, those two forces must satisfy the following criterion. So obviously the first two we know they got to be equal in magnitude, they've got to point in the opposite direction. These two forces satisfy those two, it's the other two that they fall apart on. So they also must be the same type of force. And so here you notice one of them is a gravitational force, the other is a normal. You also have to switch which object feels the force and which object causes the force. So both of these objects are in the free body diagram of the box because they're felt by the box. One of them is caused by the Earth. The gravitational force is caused by the Earth. The other one, the normal, is caused by the surface. So if you want to go looking for the Newton's third law pair for the gravitational force on the box by the Earth, you need to find a gravitational force that's exerted on the Earth by the box. So we have to have the same first subscript, type of force has got to be the same, and we're switching the second and third. So which force or which object causes the force and which object feels the force. So the Newton's third law pair for the gravitational force exerted on the box by the Earth is a gravitational force. It does point up. It's in the free body diagram of the Earth, right? Because that's the force that feels the third law pair to this one. And it's equal in magnitude to the weight of the box. So it has the same magnitude as the gravitational force on the box by the Earth. If you want to talk about the Newton's third law pair to the normal, so that's going to be, so the Newton's third law pair to the normal force exerted on the box by the surface will be a normal force exerted on the surface by the box. So it's still going to be a normal force, but of course it's going to point down because the box sitting on top of the surface pushes down on the surface. It's going to be in the free body diagram of the surface because again, that's the object that now feels this third law pair force. It's going to be equal in magnitude to the normal force exerted on the box by the surface. That happens to be equal in magnitude to the weight of the box from Newton's second law. So notice that we have sort of two statements about magnitude here. One is that the box pushes down on the surface with the same magnitude as the surface pushes up on the box. That's Newton's third law. But because that normal acting on the box has to cancel out the weight of the box, because Newton's second law tells us that since the box is just sitting there, the forces acting on the box have to balance. That means the magnitude of how hard the box pushes down on the surface is equal to the weight of the box. So that additional statement about the magnitude of the normal that the box exerts on the surface and the surface exerts on the box, those actually come from Newton's second law, not Newton's third.